We can't continue to allow China to rape our country, and that's what they're doing.
Explain to us how you think about the U.S.-China relationship, given some of the comments that Donald Trump has made about China being a currency manipulator. Did that come up during your meeting?
Well, I think first, in America, there's a freedom of speech, right? So he can say whatever he wants, and I respect, I understand. But of course, I have my views. We did not debate about the China-U.S. trade or manipulation. We did not debate. Actually, we agreed on something. Small business, developing the Middle West America, helping the farmers there, small business there, the exporting to China. So we all agreed. But something that we did not discuss about the, you know, the American, the job losing to China, Mexico, and this. I think 30 years ago, when I just graduated from universities, I heard America had a wonderful strategy. They outsource the manufacturing job, service jobs. They outsource the manufacturer to Mexico and China. Outsource the service job to India. There's a book called The World is Flat.
Tom Friedman,
yeah,
colleague at the New York Times.
And I think it's a perfect strategy. You know, that the Americans said, we just want to control the IP, we just want to technology, we just want to brand, to leave the lower end jobs for the world. Great strategy. Past the 30 years, the American had 13 wars, spending $14.2 trillion. The money going there. What if they spend a part of that money on building up the infrastructure, helping the white collars and blue collars? No matter how strategy good it is, you're supposed to spend money on your own people. Not everybody can pass Harvard. Like me, they're not good at education, right? We should spend money on those people who are not good at schooling. And the other money, which I'm curious about, is that when I was young, I heard America is about Ford and Boeing, those big manufacturing companies. Last 10, 20 years, I heard about is Silicon Valley and Wall Street. The money go to the Wall Street. And what happened? Year 2008. The financial crisis wiped out $19.2 trillion, USA alone. They wiped all the white collars and destroyed 34 million jobs globally. So what if the money, it's not Wall Street, what if the money spent on the middle west of the United States, developing the industry there, that could be changed a lot. So it's not the other countries steal jobs from you guys. It is your strategy.
Okay,
but you do not distribute the money and things in a proper way.